Hi, I'm Annie with ByAnnie.com and Patterns by Annie, and I'd like to give you a little bit more information about our pattern, Courtside. Courtside is made with a combination of quilted and non-quilted parts to give a more modern look and to simplify the construction process. Quilted fabric is used for the main body of the bag. This includes the body front and body back, as well as the zipper loop. Additional pockets are attached to the front and back, inside and out, and are connected to the bag body at the sides and bottom. If you have made our free pattern Easy Does It, or our Ultimate Travel Bag or Round Trip Duffel, the process of assembling Courtside will be very familiar to you. The Courtside pattern recommends four fabrics, including two main fabrics. The main one fabric is used for the body of the bag, the side pocket, front of the inner divider, and for the padded straps and their bindings. The main two fabric is used for the front and back pockets and the trolley sleeve. These pockets are the perfect spot to use a fabric with a predominant motif or to highlight a patchwork block. In addition to the two main fabrics, the pattern also calls for a lining fabric, which is used for the lining of the bag body, pockets, inner divider, and for the inside binding. Finally, a coordinating fabric is used for the handle, straps, strap tabs, and a facing at the bottom of the front pocket. Of course, if you prefer to mix things up, add more fabrics, or even just use one main fabric, you can certainly do that. Just know that you'll need to come up with your own cutting layouts, and you may need different amounts of fabric than what is called for on the supply list. Directional fabrics will work fine for this project, and the pattern includes tips for their use. On this bag, we used several different fabrics. To avoid cutting through the lady, we centered her on the left of the front pocket and used a black and white stripe for the right side. I love how that stripe moves your eye right to the lady. We substituted the coordinating fabric for the back pocket and added another fun focus fabric in a smaller scale for the trolley sleeve. We used that same fabric for the inner divider and the bottom of the inner zippered pocket, again using the black and white stripe for the top of the inner zippered pocket. You will need to put some careful thought into cutting pieces if you are using directional fabrics or fabrics with predominant motifs. Because of the way Courtside is designed, most of the bag front and back are covered by the front and back pockets. So for this bag, we used a variety of more solid or plain prints for the bag front, back, and zipper loop, as well as for the side pocket, back pocket, and inner zippered pocket. Then we fussy cut the hero fabric for just the front pocket, the trolley sleeve, and the inner divider. We added an additional coordinating fabric for the lining of the inner divider. As always, we recommend that you make at least one bag using non-directional designs before making a bag using your more precious fabrics. That way, you'll have a better idea of how everything comes together and what you'll need to consider when cutting. For this colorful bag, we used mesh instead of fabric and soft and stable for the side pocket. We cut the mesh to the same size as directed for the side pocket and bound its top and bottom edges with fold-over elastic. You will find a full list of supplies on the back cover of the Courtside pattern. If you don't yet have the pattern, you can also find the list on the Courtside product page at ByAnnie.com. Just click on the Supply List tab. Courtside uses basic skills used in many ByAnnie patterns. It has lots of awesome features, which means it has many pieces and multiple layers. So we recommend it for intermediate to advanced sewists using a sewing machine that can handle bulk. To help ensure success, we filmed an add-on video for Courtside. It will help you conceptualize the project and take you through the more unique or challenging parts of the pattern, including preparing front pocket A, preparing the bellowed inner divider, and attaching the body back to the zipper loop and binding its raw edges. Just take your time, check off each step as you proceed, and enjoy the process. Before you know it, you'll have a great Courtside backpack duffel for your active lifestyle. We cannot wait to see what you make and how you use these functional bags, so be sure to share pictures of your finished projects with us. Find us on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, and YouTube by using @PatternsByAnnie. Be sure to enter our monthly photo contest too. Thank you so much for watching. Happy stitching!